Happy morning, children. I am your physical science teacher. Hope you all received your October monthly test portion. In chemistry, you have only one lesson, lesson number 9, solutions. Evaluation answers are given for the questions in your assignment. Children, you go through the link. This lesson has got choose the correct answer, fill in the blanks, match the following, true or false, short answer, answer in detail. In our today's class, we will discuss some of the answers for the questions. Watch the video and prepare well for your exam. Thank you, children.
First, we'll see book bag exercises. Roman letter 1. Choose the correct answer. First one, a solution is a dash mixture. Answer A, homogeneous. Second one, the number of components in a binary solution is dash. Option A, answer 2. Third one, which of the following is the universal solvent? Answer is C, water. Fourth one, a solution in which no more solute can be dissolved in a definite amount of solvent at a given temperature is called dash. The answer is A, saturated solution. Fifth one, identify the non-aqueous solution. Answer is D, sulfur in carbon disulfide. Sixth one, when pressure is increased at constant temperature, the solubility of gases in liquid is dash. Answer is B, increases. Seventh one, solubility of NaCl in 100 ml of water is 36 gram. If 25 gram of salt is dissolved in 100 ml of water, how much more solute is required for saturation? Dash. The answer is B, 11 gram. Then a bracket, 36 minus 25. Eighth one. Yeah, 25% alcohol solution means dash. Answer is C, 25 ml alcohol in 75 ml of water. Ninth one, deliquescence is due to dash. The answer is A, strong affinity to water. Next, 10th one, which of the following is hygroscopic in nature? Dash. The answer is C, silica gel. Choose the correct answer is over. Next, we'll see Roman letter 2, filling the blanks. First question, the component present in lesser amount in a solution is called dash. The answer is solute. Second question, example for liquid and solid type solution is dash. Answer, mercury with sodium. Third one, solubility is the amount of solute dissolved in dash gram of solvent. Answer is 100. So solute dissolved in 100 gram of solvent. Next, fourth question, polar compounds are soluble in dash solvents. Answer is polar. So polar compounds are soluble in polar solvents. Fifth one, volume percentage decreases with increase in temperature because dash the answer is expansion of liquid. Okay, next we'll see Roman letter 3. Match the following. First question, blue vitriol. Second, gypsum. Third one, deliquescence. Fourth one, hygroscopic. Next we'll see the answers for this. First one, blue vitriol. Answer CuSO4.5H2O. This is the formula for blue vitriol. Next, gypsum. Formula CaSO4.2H2O. Next, third one, deliquescence. Answer NaOH. Fourth one, hygroscopic. Answer BCaO. Okay, so match the following is over. Next, we'll move on to the Roman letter 4. True or false? If false, give the correct statement. Okay. First question, solutions which contain three components are called binary solution. Answer is false. The given statement is false. So write the statement. Solutions which contains two components are called binary solutions. Okay. Second question. In a solution, the component which is present in lesser amount is called solvent. The answer is false. The given statement is false. So correct this statement. In a solution, the component which is present in higher amount is called solvent. Next, third one, sodium chloride dissolved in water forms a non-aqueous solution. Answer is false. So correct the statement. Sodium chloride dissolved in water forms a aqueous solution. Next, question number 4. The molecular formula of green vitriol is MgSO4.7H2O. The statement is false. So the correct statement is molecular formula of Epsom salt is MgSO4.7H2O. Okay. Next, fifth one. When silico gel is kept open, it absorbs moisture from the air because it is hygroscopic in nature. The answer is true. So true or false is over. Roman letter 4. Next we'll see Roman letter 5. Short answer questions. First question, define the term solution. What's the answer? A solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances called solution. Next, second question, what does mean by binary solution? A solution contains two components is called binary solution. One solute and one solvent. It's called binary solutions. Example, salt in water, sugar in water. The example for binary solution. Next, third question. Give an example for each. First one, gas and liquid. Second, solid and liquid. Third one, solid and solid. Fourth one, gas and gas. We'll see the example for each one. First one, gas and liquid. Example, soda, water. Second, solid in liquid. Example, sodium chloride in water. Third one, solid in solid. Example, copper dissolved in gold alloys. Fourth one, gas in gas. Example, mixture of helium O2 gases. Question number 4. What is aqueous and non-aqueous solution? Give an example. First, we will see what is aqueous solution. The solution in which water acts as a solvent is called aqueous solution. The solution in which water acts as a solvent is called aqueous solution. Example, common salt in water, sugar in water. This is the example for aqueous solution. Second one, non-aqueous solution. So what is non-aqueous solution? The solution in which any liquid, the solution in which any liquid other than water acts as a solvent is called non-aqueous solution. Example, sulfur dissolved in carbon disulfide. Another example, iodine dissolved in CCl4, carbon tetrachloride. Next, question number 5. Define volume percentage. Volume percentage is defined as the percentage by volume of solute present in the given volume of the solution. Next, you write the formula. Volume percentage is equal to volume of the solute divided by volume of the solute plus volume of the solvent into 100. Next, volume percentage is equal to the numerator, you write the same, volume of the solute divided by volume of the solution into 100. Next, question number 6. The aquatic animals live more in cold regions. Why? The answer, because more amount of dissolved oxygen is present in the water of cold regions. This shows that the solubility of oxygen in water is more at low temperature. Next, question number 7. Define hydrated salt. Answer, the number of water molecules found in the crystalline substance is called water of crystallization. Such salts are called hydrated salts. Next question number 8. A hot saturated solution of copper sulfate forms crystals as it cools. Why? The answer is the number of water molecules in blue vitriol is 5. So its water of crystallization is 5. When blue colored copper sulfate crystals are gently heated, it loses its 5 water molecules and becomes anhydrous copper sulfate. Then add a few drops of water or allow it to cool. The colorless anhydrous salt again turns back into blue colored hydrated salt. Next question number 9. Classify the following substances into deliquescent hygroscopic. Here, concentrated sulfuric acid, copper sulfate, pentahydrate, silica gel, calcium chloride and gypsum salt is given. First, you write it in a tabular column. First column, deliquescence. Second one, hygroscopic. You write what are the deliquescent substance are here. Only one deliquescent substance is written here, given here. That is calcium chloride. Next, for hygroscopic, here 4 substances are given. First one, concentrated sulfuric acid is given. Formula for sulfuric acid is H2SO4. So for hygroscopic, first one, concentrated H2SO4. And then second one, silica gel is given. Third one, copper sulfate pentahydrate. The last one is gypsum salt. Next, we'll see Roman letter 6 long answer question. First question, write notes on saturated solution. First one, second one, unsaturated solution. First, we'll see what is saturated solution. A solution in which no more solute can be dissolved in a definite amount of the solvent at a given temperature is called saturated solution. Example, 36 gram of sodium chloride in 100 gram of water at 25 degree centigrade. Next, what is unsaturated solution? A solution is one that contains less solute than that of the saturated solution at a given temperature. Example, 10 gram or 20 gram or 30 gram of sodium chloride in 100 gram of water at 25 degree centigrade forms unsaturated solution. Next, second one, write notes on various factors affecting solubility. There are 3 main factors which govern the solubility of solute. They are, first one, nature of the solute and solvent. Second one, temperature. Third one, pressure. We'll say one by one. First one, nature of the solute and solvent. The nature of the solute and solvent plays an important role in solubility. Although water dissolves in an enormous variety of substances, both ionic and covalent, but it does not dissolve everything. For example, common salt is a polar compound and dissolves in polar solvent like water. Non-polar compounds are soluble in non-polar solvents. For example, fat dissolved in ether. The second one, effect of temperature. Solubility of a solute in a liquid solvent increases with increase in temperature. In endothermic process, this solubility increases with increase in temperature. In exothermic process, this solubility decreases with increase in temperature. Next, solubility of a gas in liquid. Solubility of gases in liquid decrease with increasing temperature. Generally, water contains dissolved oxygen. When water is boiled, the solubility of oxygen in water decreases. So, oxygen escapes in the form of bubbles. Next, effect of pressure. When the pressure is increased, the solubility of a gas in liquid increases. Example, carbonated beverages. Third question, what happens when MgSO4.7H2O is heated? Write the appropriate equation. Its water of crystallization is 7. When magnesium sulfate heptahydrate crystals are gently heated, it loses 7 water molecules and becomes an anhydrous magnesium sulfate. Example, equation MgSO4.7H2O gives MgSO4 plus 7H2O. Magnesium sulfate heptahydrate after heating becomes anhydrous magnesium sulfate. Then B question, define solubility. Solubility is defined as the number of grams of solute that can be dissolved in 100 gram of a solvent to form its saturated solution at a given temperature and pressure. For example,